just keep that steady for a while. This, put that over here. That. There we go. Nice, easy, and it makes me look festive. One gentleman's Christmas top. Oh dear, I seem to have left the camera running. Hello, and welcome to the Christmas edition of the Gentleman Gamer. Really nothing else I can say for the title. Roll those opening credits! Very greatly to the holiday season. As you can see, I've got my tinsel up, I've got cards, and I do believe the angry video game nerd said it best when he said,
Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy everybody, Happy Holidays. And if you have a problem with Happy Holidays, then Happy shut the fuck up.
Indeed. Now, because it is the holiday season, I think that I should focus strictly on snow and winter-based levels. Two games today, Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 and Super Street Fighter 4. So for Ultimate Marvel Capcom 3, it'll be Bone Wonderland. Not going to say anything about that title. And Mother Russia from Super Street Fighter 4. So, without further ado, let's begin by looking at Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Our first match today is me playing as one of my usual teams, the Sentinel, Frank, and Hagar, against a Wesker, Trish, and Hawkeye team. This team will be very adept to keep away, I believe. Because you can use Wesker's gunshot, Trish's scythe, and Hawkeye's bows and arrows. So I get off to a pretty bad start with my Sentinel. Just getting completely pwned by the West, because I have to drop from the top automatically getting up to legacy. A very simple combo. I try to hyper, he dodges it using the Wesker teleport, and he's back to square one. He tries and pulls out a gun, I give him a shopping cart. Now I must admit, like most people, Trish is one of my worst matchups. Flight, traps, keep away, and her actual physical attacks don't do too badly either. But all in all, she is like the most, she is the arsiest of this game. Well rounded in every respect. So anyway, I've always been trying to pull out Hagar as soon as we get to go there. Happy birthday!
You will not survive.
Then comes the Maximum Wesker. Thankfully, Hagar is in court. But I can't follow up one of my friend West's things.
Yeah, now we're talking.
I give him another bloody shopping cart to the face. Let's face it. Shopping carts to the face are the least that Albert Wesker can hope for after all he's done. Anyway, I hard tag Sentinel straight back in, but the hyper Sentinel force there just barely catching Trish. She comes in with a dive kick, and from my character moving, put 2 hits of hyper armor on it, or super armor, whatever you want to call it. In comes Frank, hard tag Sentinel, to let Frank gain more health. Hyper Sentinel falls straight into the Hawkeye. Magma Beam. I don't like using projectiles too much. I mean, I will admit that. Yes, I will use projectiles on Arthur.
soundtrack. Or, hell, I'll even use my own. Ah, cinematic finish. Dead meat! Albert West got Hong Yang to the other side of the stage. Again? As Frank West runs away from the zombies that probably the Umbrella Corporation created. But yeah, going back to what I was saying, I'm not a big projectile fan. I find keep away games are not in the spirit of fighting. But onto Team Zombie Politics, as I like to call it, with Nemesis, Ishenko, and Hagar versus Wesker. Strider and Hawkeye. Again, a very good team. A lot of power. But Nemesis just gets pwned at the moment by Wesker. But, I managed to stop his combo and get in a lucky launch. Thankfully, I delay hyper combo into Ishenko Gold Arm State, which means infinite hyper armor, so she'll continue to do whatever she wants in her assist. Unfortunately, she will still take damage. That's the only problem. But then again, that was the problem with Phoenix Wright, and Capcom released the Heroes of Hades patch, which fixed that little problem. This is where Hagar is really in the heat. As you saw right there, they needed to give Hagar a projectile of some sort. Even if it was just something crazy from the game, like throwing an oil barrel, it should have been in there. Still, Shenko beats Wesker. Don't do that every day. Now it's just all about trying to get in that launcher. That launcher that would decide which. Ooh! Lucky tag in there. Lucky with Nemesis. Oh, and the cycle begins again. Into the bio. Is it Bioshock Rush? No, it's not Bioshock. That's a whole different game altogether. We'll review it at some point. Anyway, so I don't know how I've done it, but I managed to keep Shenko and Nemesis alive at all time now. But here comes level 3 Strider with Ouroboros. This is a nasty little piece of work. I'll tag in Shenko. I try and go for the swords. No idea what the actual name is. It's probably from Japanese that I can't pronounce. No, that's not offensive to Japanese. I didn't learn Japanese before, so I have no idea how the words are pronounced. Except for Konnichiwa, and that's about it. Now, this is... I screw up the inputs here. Well, no, I didn't screw up the input. I screwed up the timing. Timing! No, I screwed up the timing. I tried to call in the assist without the gold armor. If I had the gold armor, fine. Wrong hyper armor there, into the Ouroboros. Nemesis is down. Now, Shenko does not do well against these kind of rushed-down, high-stake characters. I go one more time into the gold armor. I should have tried using, like, the balls or something, but no, I lose. That's entirely my fault. Too good for the likes of you. I still think I would have lost, though, but still, not well done on the guy. Still on to the last Ultimate Lovers Capcom 3 match. Shenko, Frank, and Hagar against a Wesker, Deadpool, and Amaterasu team. I'm seeing a lot of Weskers these days. No idea why. Anyway, my regular tactic is to get Shenko into gold and then get her out as an anchor. Into the maximum Wesker. Oh, I managed to heavy violent axe the dog. I honestly hate facing Amaterasu. She's so small, yet you can just mash the heavy button and go straight into launcher. Talking of which. Oh, it's into the Dead Rising cinematic. Now, if I would have X-Factored at that point, I would have made a full camera, but I don't think I've wasted X-Factor just yet.
You've disappointed me.
There's a lot of advanced stuff you can do with your team just getting into level 5. Hell, even level 4 will be. In fact, no, tell a lie. Level 3. Level 3 would definitely help me. But now he's in level 2. Jenko's gold ability is just awesome. Yes, she's not exactly the most conventional character, yes, she's the best ever. She still manages to keep her eyes to be considered a threat. I don't know if you can do a relaunch combo from the down pipe or whatever, but down goes Deadpool, Wesker is on his last leg. I'm currently rushing him down with all kinds of attacks. Oh, I meant I don't capitalize as often as I should on that down heavy flying axe. Anyway, the Mayor of Earth is down. His pipe was not righteous. No. It now comes down to a photographer and also Wesker. Plunge to the heart! Oh yeah, that's a new meme I've come up with if you check my website.
Salty, but look at that Joker. I mean, come on, he blatantly rage quit after I... Shouldn't be making that. Hello? Yes, I did say rage quit. No, you mustn't! Oh no. Did I hear someone say, rage quit? Rage, what are you doing here? I don't care if the guy did rage quit, to be quite honest. You know what? Screw it. I need a cup of tea. You can splurt out your gobbledygook if you want to. Just fine. Yes, I am former WWEFG wrestler. Rage quit! I punish those who rage quit during video games, pile driving them until they are nothing. I was trained by the Ultimate Warrior in one of his academies. Probably that's why I'm completely mad. But that's besides the point. You, whoever decided to rage quit while having Albert Wesker manly having his heart stabbed out with a plunger, I give you this ultimatum. Meet me and I will pile drive you.
Sorry about the mistake, folks, that wasn't the last match. My team is Sentinel, Arthur, and Hagar against a rather unusual team of Sea Viper, Hulk, and Wolverine. Three characters you don't exactly see that all that often anymore on the old internet. Which is quite a shame considering they all have good technology. Anyway, into the team aerial combo and use Arthur's OTG fire bottle into Goddess Bracelet, mashing the hell out of the heavy attack button to increase its power. As much as I said that I don't like using projectiles too much, as I said, with a character like Arthur who needs to primarily focus upon his projectiles because, let's face it, he can't do really much else, it kinda has to be done. However, as you can see, I abuse the hell out of it and I still try and attack with a few physical attacks here and there, so you can't exactly blame me for being a complete scrub. Anyway, I defeat Wolverine, so in comes the Hulk. He manages to happy birthday both Sentinel and Hagar, but thankfully Hagar's hitbox is so big that the team aerial combination he was going for screwed up. I managed to air-S Hulk light rocket punch into the OTG, into Plasma Storm, into the Hypersonic Force with a crouching M. Normally that wouldn't work, however I think I got a little bit lucky. Anyway, thanks to Arthur's magical daggers stunning the Hulk long enough, Crouching M manages to take him out. I catch Sea Viper on the way in with my Sentinel. However, that fire bottle in gold armor has got such a different trajectory rate that it really needs to be adhered to. Okay. because as you saw, I screwed up that particular combination and got punished for it. However, thanks to a cross-up between Earth and Hagar, I still managed to win. So yeah, continue to use Viper, Hulk, and Wolverine despite their changes. Okay, as much as I hate Wolverine because he's such a cheap-ass character. Anyway, on to the next match. It's my Shenko, Frank, and Hagar team making its triumphant return against a Virgil, Ryu, and Chris. Now, I'll admit, I've been getting into Chris as of lately. And no, that's not an innuendo. I've actually been playing as Chris Redfield in the training mode and single player modes, and I've even done a couple of online matches with him. He has got a lot of potential. I just need to tighten up the combinations and stuff. Anyway, I failed at command grab, but I managed to get Shenko into gold and swap her out with Hagar. Now, I don't know if you saw that, but Virgil got hit behind Hagar with the Violent Axe. How exactly did that work? I mean, I know he went into Rapid Slash, but seriously, that was just manic. Anyway, there's Ryu getting caught with the Team Aerial combination. Down he goes, into the balls. Oh, a whiffed Rapid Punch from Hagar. But thanks to the air pipe, it's into another aerial combination, to which Ryu succumbs and falls. Anyway, Chris Redfield, Hero of Raccoon City, is up next. Just punches Hagar straight in the face. Doesn't do much, but it's still funny as hell. I don't know why, but I keep whiffing the launcher after that heavy Violent Axe. Whoa, did you see that? The grenade exploded on top of Hagar as he was doing his down H, and it still continued. Does that move her hyper armor? I'm gonna have to test that in training mode at some point. Anyway, into the body splash. Doesn't do a lot of damage. Oh, that magnum shot can go and screw itself. That thing is just so overpowered. And does a wall bounce. I know magnums are powerful, but they're not that bloody powerful. Okay, into the grenade launcher. I don't know why I backdash at that point. That is just an utter mistake. Into the cinematic. Dead meat! Love it. Absolutely love it. He tries and magnums me. I don't know why, but Frank seems to have this amazing ability to just duck underneath most projectiles, but I get caught with that last grenade, into the flamethrower, here comes Shenko taking a lot of damage, but she manages to win me the fight with the down H. Oh yeah!
Oh, look at that guy, he played until the end, he played very well. No, Rage, he did actually play to the... Yes, he did! He did win! No, Rage, he did actually play to the... You've actually seen this video, haven't you? Yes, he did! You know what? Fine, go ahead. Do your thing. Yes! Another Ultimatum to those who fall to your might of Rage. Stop doing it! Now! Otherwise, I will pile-drive you, like I pile-drive Hulk Hogan, into the ground! So that was my few matches on Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Now, we're going to move on to Super Street Fighter... Whoa, what the hell? Who the... Signal... Jammed... God damn it! Stop! You bloody, worthless English pig! Who the hell are you? I am the chef. I was trained underneath God of cooking, Gordon Ramsay. It's where I learned to blacken my heart and swear like commoner, you bastard. You, yes, gentlemen, as you like to call yourself. Allow me to ask you this as a Frenchman to an Englishman. Have you done what your parents asked?
The vacuuming and the polishing?
Yeah! Wait, what? No! Not the housework! I'm on about preparing after dinner desserts! Or treats, as they call them. Disgusting English word!
Ah, right. I forgot about that. No, don't get up from your ruddy seat. I shall do it. I, who trained under Gordon Ramsay, who learned to swear like Gordon Ramsay, who watched every episode of the F-Word, Kid Gordon Ramsay, shall teach you how to make Le Chef's chocolate Christmas treats. Before you can start cooking, you need three things to begin with. Milk chocolate, white chocolate, and let's not forget plain or dark chocolate. Tossing chocolate makes me feel powerful, like Gordon Ramsay, you maggot!
There are two ways in which you can temper chocolate. The first is by the traditional method of heating up a pan of water and putting Pyrex bowl over it. Weak way of it. Back in Soviet Russia, we had chocolate in hand when we put it over hot flames. Anyway, the second way is to put it all into Pyrex jugs and temper it in microwave, melting it to its pathetic, weak, gooey state. Unfortunately, though, it's the only way you can actually make the treats. Disgusting word. Yes, you want to temper it 1 minute at a time. Until it goes nice and sloppy like that.
Are you paying attention to me, gamer? Considering I am cooking your desserts.
Of course I am.
You better be. Also, are you up for how do you say? Video games later?
Of course!
As you can see, traditional method works well.
It's melting like the wind.
Nice and smooth, like baby's arse.
It's melting like my pants in summer.
Warning, this scene may be inappropriate. Next you take the cherry brandy, which I love. I love cherry brandy. I want to have its babies. And then taking really tiny spoon. You just pour it in and mix it. It should remain smooth.
Still not working. Hello, is this Miss Money Penny? Oh, hello, Miss Money Penny. Yes, it's a pleasure to hear from you too. But can I reimburse myself on that enchantments course again? He says both pieces that I tried to do for that final project last time, haven't quite worked. I just need to redo it one more time, just to get all the basics, etc. Again? Excellent. It's not going to cost me anything, is it? It's covered by the GGS? Excellent, it's covered by the GGS. Right. Tell the GGS I'll be in on Monday. Thank you very much. See ya. Yes! There you are.
Now that all three chocolates have been melted into delicious, fucking delicious states, you can now start to filter. That's it. Pour it in. Pour it in like nitroglycerin into bombs. Not that I'd know anything about that. Once patented, put in freezer. Delicious.
And after you've completed everything, open to where your ice bank or ice tray is. Open it very carefully. Place it inside very carefully. Close it very carefully. Make sure nothing gets in the friggin' way. Stupid bloody ice bag. Who fucking came up with this shit? Close it up before it loses too much cold, you moron. And there you have it! One tray of delicious alcoholic chocolatey goodness! Now then, you little turd! I am leaving!
At this location!
The first match of Super Street Fighter 4 is my Zangief versus M. Bison, aka the Dictator, aka the leader of Shadaloo, or however you pronounce it. I managed to catch him off guard a couple times at the double lariat, but he quickly adapts to my strategy of just hammer on the double lariat until you can get a pole driver. But he psycho crushes straight into it. I try a banishing flat, doesn't quite work, into double lariat. Oh, I catch him with a focus attack. Double hit. And it's a KO with a double lariat. Woo! Russian wrestling number one. Into round two. Teleporting out of the way into the head stomp. Again into the head stomp. But at least I managed to cancel out this one. But he knows how to destroy that lariat. Let's just duck down and mash on the light button. Or a light button. Double hit there from EX Psycho Crusher along with... EX Scissor Kick along with that. I tried EX Banishing Flat. Doesn't quite work. EX Banishing Flat technically hit. Unfortunately though, it was blocked. EX Pile Driver. Now that's what I'm talking about. Ah, the Psycho Crusher didn't quite work. Teleport. Oh, double lariat. I try an E-expansion flat, but it's absolutely nothing against this. I have no idea what it's called. Psycho Cannon or something like that. Either way, he beat me using Ultra Combination 1. And it's into the third and final round. Getting off to a good start there with the scissor kick, and I managed to retaliate there with my lariat. Psycho Crusher into slide, head stomp, psycho dive. I call that psycho dive. Sliding kick into the lariat. Jesus, here we go. I managed to catch him off guard with a throw into the double lariat. This is all looking good for me. I managed to catch him there with double lariat. He gets me again with the EX Psycho Crusher. I get an EX Banishing Flat into the... Oh, I tried a focus attack, that didn't quite work yet, so EX Banishing Flat again. I try and go for a double lariat, but he catches me with the Ultra Combination 1 again. It's all over. Zangief is defeated. M. Bison wins. That's a double Ultra Combination finish. God damn it. Should have just tried to go for Mother Ultimate Atomic Buster. Oh well, on to my next match. I'm playing as Zangief again, but I'm going against Seth. Gets up me with a double, triple head stomp. Throw this again, but get ready to get one that time. And that time. Just a lot of jumping around, looking more like Russian ballet than Russian wrestling. Ah, there we go, double lariat. Well, I try and go for a pole drive, but it doesn't quite work. However, I managed to get in with lariat. Into the triple shot Ruken. Again, triple shot Ruken after he gets it behind the lariat. He tries and sucks me in using the black hole generator. I don't care what it's officially called, it's what I call it. He tries and goes with the power of the tundra or whatever he calls it. He tries and goes with the 20 hit kick. Doesn't quite work. I counter the double lariat. That's the end of round numero uno. Into round two. Fight! Zangief can't do much against projectiles such as the Sonic Boom. Anyway, double lariat, he goes EX Shoryuken. What was that, 7? 6 hits? 6 hits. I try and go for super combination, I was just out. So I managed to catch him double lariat. Now he is starting to really pound me down at this point. He really has got a stranglehold on me at this point. He is starting to up his game. However, double lariat, he gets me double sonic boom into the EX Shoryuken. I try and go stupidly for the ultra combination. God knows how Zangief actually survives this onslaught. I actually go against hope here. I go against the grain, double lariat with the three kick moves, so it's actually shorter. But yeah, somehow I managed to win. So yeah, it's one win and one loss. On to my next match. It's Guy versus Cody. Guy versus Cody. It's Guy versus Dudley, British boxing champion. I'm Dudley. I actually like Dudley. He's actually one of my favourite moves. One of my favourite characters, despite the fact that he didn't actually play Third Strike. I was really only introduced to him in Super Street Fighter 4, and I instantly fell in love with him. No idea why, but no homo. Anyway, this guy is just incredible. He wears me down. I have no idea how on earth I even connected with that hit, with that throw, but it kind of gets me into a bit of a groove, as it got me the EX machine gun blow. I try and go with uppercut. At this point, it's practically just all over, so yeah, I don't so much give up as I do relent. I mean, what, I only had like a pixel of health left? Anyway, Guy runs off after killing Dudley, only to come back to find that he only knocked him out. So here we go again, round number two. I managed to get the first attack in this time, which is always good mentally. I just gotta bide my time against this ninja. Decent, aren't I, yeah?
Keep it classy!
I try and go for a keep it classy, but it doesn't quite work. Ah, jet uppercut. Yeah, that's not my bad. Again, I'm trying to wear him down just as he brought me down into the EX Hurricane Kick. Don't actually troll me if I don't get these names right with the moves, okay? Anyway, into a throw, so I'm currently leading on life with 60 seconds to go. It's still anybody's match. Don't ever let the health bar fool you. Jet up to get out of the way. He whiffs the ultra combination because I guard, and I managed to punch Guy straight in the face. Boom! Anyway, into round three, and this really is still all to play for. Again, I get the first hit attack. Good, man. That gives you a boost mentally, but it also drives the other guy to do well as well. It's just basically an exchange of blows at the moment. None of these characters have projectiles, so it is close quarters. Anyway, I try and go in there with the EX machine gun blow, doesn't quite work.
Keep it classy.
Again, the machine gun blow doesn't work. I try coming in from the air. Focus attack, it dodges it. I'm trying a lot of different techniques here. But I just can't seem to get it good in any ways. Managed to hit him with something. Weird going down a little bit with the machine gun blow. I managed to catch him with a corkscrew cross. Now this could end the match. He goes flying into the wall and boom! KO! Oh, oh. Guy is beaten by being smashed against a wall. I can't actually believe I won that. My next match is Zangief versus Guy. This is the same guy as in the same guy as in the same player who plays as Guy, as well as Guy as in the definitive term for random person you've met before. But yeah, this is the same guy playing as Guy. And me with my Zangief. This is such a different setup, but I honestly didn't see it coming because I did a quick match or something like that. But no, despite the fact that Zangief has a major strength advantage over Guy, he was just being worn down by the speed and dexterity of those moves. But I managed to catch him with the ultra combination. I have no idea how he survived that double lariat, but it doesn't really matter. He gets me with his ultra one, beating the double lariat, and smashing Zangief into the floor. Now, if anybody did that in real life, their spine would be nothing but splinters. I'm not even joking. But into round number two. I just have to buy my time at this point because I know exactly what he's going to try and do. I think he knows exactly what I'm going to try and do too. So I anti-air him. catch him off guard of the Lucky Lariat. He manages to light, well, to tap his way out of my focus attack. EX banish him flat. I have no idea if he can actually follow the EX banish him flat on anything. I'm gonna have to do a bit of fashion to banish him. Into the double lariat. I try and throw him, but he manages to catch me off again. Again, double lariat. He tries some EX attack of his own. EX banish him flat, managed to catch him off. Oh, and look at that. The same situation as last time. I try the double lariat. He goes into Ultra Combination 1 and KO! Not only does he get 2 wins in a row, getting a perfect match, but he also gets 2 Ultra Combination finishes. That guy plays very well. He plays very well.
Well, a few wins, a few losses. Not a bad day for me. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you so much for spending part of the Christmas holiday with me, the humble old gentleman gamer. Thanks. There's really nothing left for me to say other than Merry Christmas, folks. Good tidings to all men, etc., etc. Keep it classy, as always. Guys, you got anything to add?
Yes, yes, from all of us here at Ant-Man Movies, I, Le Chef, wish you a Merry Christmas. Rage Quit demands that you all say Merry Christmas to me now. But in all seriousness, though, happy holidays and Merry Christmas, you scum.
Ladies and gentlemen, Merry Christmas, and please, keep it classy. I am the Gentleman Gamer, signing off for the last time on 2011. You won't see me until January next year. Out of a ditch. I'm off to go and get clattered. Christmas festivities, here I come. At least I finally figured out what you are, my little friend. You are a robot from the Doctor Who series called a Dalek. Yes, I know, they're bio-organic life forms trapped inside suits of armour like knights who have had their skin welded, but whatever. Merry Christmas, and I'm off. Dad, chill that cider.
Extermination begins. In 2 months' time, when batteries are fully charged and operational.
Good. He has no idea that I'm waiting for him. 2 months, you say? That is perfectly acceptable. The anticipation of the hunt and of the kill make victory all the sweeter.